Stop taking twos now? You're 0-for-3 from two.
I missed some easy floaters, some tippies, but I knew I had to start making threes and off the dribble and catch and shoot, because teams I play them, they scared of me getting in the paint and beating them off the dribble. So they give me a lot of space, and I told myself I gotta start knocking those shots down.
You're down 10 late first half. That three at the halftime buzzer began the first of two 17-0 runs. Offensively, what changed for UConn in the second half?
We just started sharing the basketball and got comfortable and accustomed to that zone. In the second half, we started getting it in the four hole. And after we was getting in the middle, it was breaking down. We was getting the shots that we wanted.
And defensively, they shot 33% from the floor in the second half. And Terry Wisnat, their leading scorer coming in, was 2-for-7 from the floor, made a couple of first half threes, didn't score in the second half. You had a lot of him defensively. What did you try to take away from him, and how was he neutralized?
We just had to try to run him off the three-point line. He loves to come off screens and just shoot threes. And the whole team, first half, I think they hit 7-3. So we just wanted to take three-point line away from them and make them take the test of twos.
Yeah, and Ryan, after two straight road losses, how important was it to keep the season alive with a win tonight?
It was huge. I told the guy we had a great opportunity to come out here and get a win at home in front of our crowd in Gamble. And it could be a good way to start this 10-game winning streak that we got to get on.
All right, Ryan, thanks very much.
Thanks.